for load and carry operations to maximize revenue potential through higher production as well as safety around the job site, the Caterpillar Ride Control System incorporates a dual accumulator design. This allows operators to use a pre-charge set in the accumulators for both empty and full work tool, but it is also important to still adjust the activation speeds dependent on application. Through the main display, we will now touch the machine icon. In the settings menu, you will find the ride control option. Here, independently forward and reverse activation speeds can be set. Typical bucket operations, you will find the machine defaults to 6 miles per hour from the factory. But as we do utilize the machine in fork applications, it is common to set these much lower. As the payload moves out as far as distance from the machine, it is imperative to utilize this ride control functionality much sooner in the travel speeds. The Caterpillar system, since the Network Manager Box update back in 2015, also has additional logic to safeguard operators. Even when the activation speed forward is set very low, as soon as the machine is digging in the pile, the machine ride control system will automatically turn off momentarily to maintain full performance while loading the bucket, and therefore unimpeding the load to your truck or hoppers. Next, we will talk about the work tool change button. Now that we have lowered the ride control speed to 3 miles per hour, it's very likely that we would have put another work tool on this system. In the upper left home screen, we just selected the work tool change function. Notice that it is set to bucket. We will now hit the tool 2. These icons can be renamed using ET to say fork or anything else that is desired. When this menu selection is used, the kickout functionality is memorized, as well as whether parallel lift is enabled or disabled on the machine.